Welcome to Create, Connect, Repeat. My name is Nick Finzer, coming to you today from the Victoria Jazz Festival in British Columbia, Canada. Today we're talking about five things that you're doing wrong on social media. One, I see a lot of people posting links to things on Instagram. And the thing about Instagram, when you put it in the description, when you try to click it, you can't click it. They disabled links down below the picture, in the caption. So don't put links there, because nobody's gonna take the time to sit there, copy that out, go into Safari, paste it. Nobody's gonna do that. If you wanna put a link on Instagram, put it in your bio and send people to the bio. That leads me to number two. You have to create content that's unique to each platform. It's really hard to get people to click off of Instagram. If you have a verified account and you can have people swipe up on your story, that's a great way to get people off of Instagram onto your content. But if you're like me and you don't have a verified Instagram account, you can't do that. Create content that works for each platform. So if you're on Instagram, create engaging pictures, create stories, get people to engage with you, you know, comment back on everyone who comments on your stuff, and create a community where people want to be involved. They look forward to your next Instagram post. Curate content for each platform as it is. So when you go on Facebook, formatting things the right size for Facebook, not just having Instagram cross-promote it. You know, so create content for each platform. Even if it's similar, create it uniquely for each one so that you can take advantage of what each platform has as its advantage. When you see people just cross-posting all the time, it just comes off as lazy. So yes, sometimes I will cross-post on Instagram back to Facebook. I'll go back and actually change the text of the post and tag people in it. So it's best for Facebook, because on Instagram, the tags don't work the same way as on Facebook. You want to create the content and captions that are going to be the best for each platform. Number three, don't post native YouTube links on Facebook. Facebook doesn't like that. They want to promote their own video platform. So put your videos on Facebook. And if you're really obsessed with your YouTube video count, take a clip, post it onto Facebook, and then include a shortened link, maybe from bit.ly or, you know, Google's shortening service, that sends them over to your YouTube page or to your website. Now, Google and Facebook, they don't get along that well. They don't want to send traffic from one to the other. So when you're posting and it gives you that little nice little preview of the YouTube video, at least when I see it, it has 10% of the reach that a video when I post it native to Facebook and then share that around, that gets way more views. So I'll put up a still of the video and include a link that goes to either my website or to YouTube, a YouTube playlist with that video. Facebook wants to promote good Facebook content, which is gonna be pictures and video. That's what they want to see. They don't want to see you sending people off of their website. Don't post native YouTube links onto Facebook. Number four is being consistent. For me, I want to post at the same time every week. Maybe it doesn't end up being the same time, but I want to post on the same day of the week so people know what to expect. So on my personal YouTube, I post every Wednesday, and I try to post either on the series of duets that I have, something from the vlog that's kind of ongoing, something from my dynamic duo series, or maybe an in-studio or interview or something that's related, and I save it for Wednesday, and I know that I can create things every week that are going to be sustainable once a week. Some people are 5 days a week, 7 days a week, which is, for me, seems a little bit crazy, and like this show, Create, Connect, Repeat, once a week on Fridays. So pick a schedule, stick to the schedule, because the algorithms for the various social networks, they pick up on your regularity of posting. They want to see that you're there, they know you're going to post, so they'll show your content to more people. So give it a while. It's going to take 2, 3, 4, 6 months, 12 months, but after you start engaging for that long, after 1 year, I see way more engagement on my YouTube channel than after 6 months. So you got to stick with it, create a long-term plan, create a schedule that you're going to stick to. And number five is that we go into this blind. We just see what our friends are doing, and we kind of copy and paste what our friends are doing on this social accounts. But look to the people that are the most successful. Look at people that are way more successful than maybe us in our little jazz niche or creative music niche. You know, look to people that have large followings on Instagram, that have large followings on YouTube and Facebook, and see what they're doing in their posts, and see if you can kind of co-opt some of those types of things. It's not that you have to copy them exactly, but just go ahead and like see, like, oh, they post on this day at this time. That must be the best time for their fans. I wonder when the best time is for me. Figure that out and schedule your posts accordingly. Take what you can from them and incorporate it with your own social media strategy so that you're not just shooting into the dark. We want to make the most of the time that you have and the energy you have to create content that's going to be engaging and great. Look to people that are doing it better than you and try to steal from them and make it part of your own thing. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time.